home. I wish to present a topic about tourist destination of Tamil Nadu. As we hear the word tour, it chills our mind and rejuvenates our heart and soul. The World Tourism Day is commemorated on 27 September of every year. The aim of celebrating the World Tourism Day is to highlight social, cultural and political value of the country. On account of this day, I would like to present some of the tourist destinations that makes our state unique and remarkable. So, let's get started. The top rated tourist destination is Ooty. Ooty, also known as Udagamandala, it is a summer resort in the Western Ghats Mountain. Ooty is known for the botanical garden and this is the largest rose garden in India. The boathouse established alongside the Ooty Lake offers boating facilities to tourists. The Nilgiri Mountain Railway is a meter gauge railway built by the British and it's the only rack railway in India. Kodaikanal. Kodaikanal is a hill station in hills of the Dindigul district. It is being referred to as the Queen of Hill Stations. Kodaikanal Lake is roughly a star-shaped 110-acre lake and this is the most popular geographic landmark and tourist attraction. Bryant Park, Cocos Walk, Silver Cascade, Bearshola Falls and Pillar Rocks are the top places. Water lilies in the park spot are another pleasing sight. The town abounds in beautiful yellow wild flowers. Kodaikanal is also known for its rich flora such as eucalyptus and acacia. Kolli Hills. Kolli Hills or Kolli Malai is a small mountain range that is spread over the Namakkal district of Tamil Nadu. This area is popular with motorcycle enthusiasts because of the high altitude with 70 hairpin bends, hence called Mountain of Death. The mountains are covered with evergreen forest. Agaya Gange is a waterfall situated in Kolli Hills. Erowal. Erowal is an experimental township in Villupuram district with some of the parts in Union Territory of Puducherry in India. The main principle of Erowal is to realize human unity. It is called the City of Dawn. Erowal wants to be a universal town where everybody from various countries are able to live in peace and progressive harmony. Above all creeds, politics and nationalities. Some people from 124 countries came to Erowal with some of their native soil brought from their homeland and deposited in a marble urn. Velankanni. Velankanni is a panchayati town in Nagapattinam district that lies on the Coromandel coast of Bay of Bengal. This place is famous for most visited Roman Catholic Latin rite shrines called the Basilica of Our Lady of Good Health. The Velankanni has been chosen as one of the heritage city for heritage of the government of India. Kunnur. Kunnur is the second largest hill station of the Western Ghats in the southern part of Tamil Nadu. It is known for its tea estate in the surrounding Nilgiri Hills. Slim Park is a sprawling public garden with plants like roses and eucalyptus tree. The stream Nilgiri Mountain Railway is a meter gauge railway built between Metabalam and Ooty through Kunnur. Dolphin Nose is a vantage point with views of cascading Catherine Falls. Kuttalam. Kuttalam Falls is located in Western Ghats on Chitta River. There are total of 9 falls, of which Aindaruvi, Peruaruvi and Puliaruvi being the most prominent. The temple at the foot of the hill is cone-shaped, which has a special significance in Hindu tradition. The falls is considered a medical spa on account of medical smell in the water. Hoggenacker. Hoggenacker Falls is a waterfall on the Kaveri River on the border between Tamil Nadu and Karnataka. It is referred to as the Niagara Falls of India. It is known for bathing areas and hired boat ride vehicles. Carbonate rock present here are considered to be the oldest in South Asia. At Hoggenacker, the Kaveri River drops and creates numerous waterfalls at the water cut to rocky terrain. In some places, the waterfalls as much as 20 meters and said to sound like continual thunder. This provides improved irrigation and hydropower. Pamban Bridge. Pamban Bridge, it is in Rameswaram, which is on southeastern tip of India. It is a railway bridge which connects the town of Mandapa in mainland India with Pamban Island and Rameswaram. The Pamban Bridge was the only link between Rameswaram and the mainland until a road running parallel to it was built. This can be seen in figure 2. It was India's first sea bridge and the second largest sea bridge in India. It is designed such that the central part of the bridge opens up to allow ferry movements. This can be seen in figure 1. And next and the last is our Kanyakumari. Kanyakumari is located at the southernmost tip of Indian Peninsula. It is situated at the confluence of Bay of Bengal, the Arabian Sea and the Indian Ocean. Kanyakumari is the only place where one can enjoy the unique sight of sunset and moonrise simultaneously on full moon days. The very end of Indian subcontinent is marked by the Cape Comorin, which is another tourist hotspot in Kanyakumari. The Vivekananda Rock Memorial is built to honor of Swami Vivekananda, who is said to have attained enlightenment on the rock. Tiruvalluvar statue built adjacent to the rock is currently the 25th tallest rock in India. Hope you all enjoy the various spots. Thanks for watching my presentation.
Located in South India, There is an urban vibe that we must endeavor to sight occasionally. The capital city, Chennai, and several other cities in the state offer a delightful blend of modern and ancient and thus give any traveler a chance to revel amidst the fusion. The geography of the state makes it an unsurpassed gift for the nature lovers. From its western fronts, where it enjoys the company of the lush Western Ghats, to its east coast, where it is adorned by a long coastal stretch and an island of Rameshwaram. Tamil Nadu has plenty of tourist attractions dotting its length and breadth. Then, there are copious things to do that further enhance your experience at this impeccable destination in India. Indeed, Tamil Nadu is an inviting tourist place, the travel guide of which promises delightful experiences to cherish. In fact, the state opens its doors to those who are willing to get a new perspective without being skeptical about anything. Therefore, if you are visiting Tamil Nadu, you need to accept a different take on spirituality and culture. Yes, it is the land of Lord Murugan and Goddess Meenakshi, but then it is also the abode of Mother Mary and the resting place of St. Thomas. Tamil Nadu is a perfect place for the pilgrimage tour, where the vibrant Hindu temples are not only the haven to seek spirituality but also to be in awe of the imposing architecture and rich culture as well. Otherwise a sultry destination, Tamil Nadu is sparsely dotted with some of the most beautiful hill stations like Ooty and Kodaikanal that makes an ideal escape during the peak summer season. The famed UNESCO World Site, Nilgiri Mountain Railway, monuments of Mahabalipuram and Chola temples at Tanjavur simply add to Tamil Nadu's tourism. Not someone who's interested in history and heritage. Well, the southern side has beautiful beaches right from Chennai to Dhanaskodi, where you can spend a vacation on golden sand beaches. Seeking some adventure? Tamil Nadu has wildlife sanctuaries like Mudumalai to enjoy thrilling safaris as well as learn about rich flora and fauna. Museums like Dakshina Chitra and festivals like Mahabalipuram Dance Festival, Thai Pusam, Meenakshi Kalyanam and Pongal let you have a holistic cultural tour. And to further enhance the cultural tour experience, you can even include flavorsome Tamil Nadu cuisine that goes beyond the conventional idli, dosa and sambar. Relish delicious seafood, rice dishes and a lot of vegetarian delights. Prop up your holiday with a session of some retail therapy and take back with you local handmade items and yes, the soft and elegant silk clothes. The state of Tamil Nadu is thus rich in both aspects of cultural and natural, making it a tourist haven. Thank you.
Everyone. Today, as a part of World Tourism Day, I'm here to present some of the tourist places in India. The first place is the Bangalore Palace. The Bangalore Palace is a royal palace in Bengaluru, Karnataka. It was built during the year 1874 in the Tudor Revival style architecture with 45 towers, battlements and turrets. The interiors were decorated with elegant wood carvings, floral motifs, cornices and paintings on the ceilings. Here are some internal and external views of this palace. The next place is the Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus. The Chhatrapati Shivaji Terminus, formerly named as Victoria Terminus, is a historical terminal train station at the UNESCO World Heritage Site in Mumbai, Maharashtra. It is also called Bori Bandar. The construction started in 1878 and got completed in 1888. It is built in the Italian Gothic architectural style. Here are some views of this busy station. The next place is the Gwalior Fort. The Gwalior Fort is located in Gwalior, Madhya Pradesh. It is a hill fort in the 15th century which was built using sandstone and lime. The main palaces here are the Gujari Mahal and the Man Mandir. The second oldest record of zero in the world was found in an inscription in a small temple inside this fort. Here are some magnificent views of this fort. The next place is the Konark Sun Temple. The Konark Sun Temple is a 13th century sun temple situated in Konark and is dedicated to the Hindu god Surya. This temple is a classic illustration of the Odisha style architecture. It was declared as a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1984. This temple is designed as a chariot consisting of 24 wheels. Here are some views of this temple. The next place is the Lakshmi Vilas Palace. The Lakshmi Vilas Palace is located in Vadodara, Gujarat. It was styled and constructed by Gaikwad, a Maratha family. It was styled on the Indo-Saracenic Revival architecture and was opened to the public in 1930. Here are some of the lavishing views of this palace. The next place is the Mysore Palace. The Mysore Palace is a historical palace and the royal residence in Mysore, Karnataka. It is the official residence of the emperors of the Wadia dynasty. It is also called City of Palaces. It is built with a blend of Rajput, Mughal, Gothic and Hindu styles. Here are some views of this magnificent palace. The next place is the Pamiyans Monastery. The Pamiyans Monastery is a Buddhist monastery in Pamiyans near Penling in Sikkim. It was founded by Lama Lhasen Chempo in 1647. It is one of the oldest monasteries in Sikkim, which was built only for pure monks. Here are some vibrant views of this monastery. The next place is the All Saints Cathedral. The All Saints Cathedral, also known as Pasad Girja, is an Anglican cathedral in Prayagraj, Allahabad. It was constructed by William Emerson in the Gothic architectural style using marble, red sandstone, tile and stained glass. Here are some views of this glorious and beautiful cathedral. The last place is the Sheesh Mahal. The Sheesh Mahal is located within the Shah Bush block in Lahore Fort, Punjab. It is constructed in the Mughal architectural style. The building is lined with precious stone, convex colored mirrors and mirror mosaics. The pillars are decorated with floral motifs. Here are some views of this beautiful Mahal. Thank you.
My dear teachers and loving friends, on the occasion of World Tourism Day, I would like to share my experience about some of the beautiful tourist places in Northeast India which I visited 3 years ago. The Northeast India tourism boasts of places of beauty where nature flourishes with all its glory. Situated amidst the many hilltops and scenic valleys, a beautiful place to visit when travelling to Northeast, paint a picture that we need to see to believe. The clouds floating right by our side and the sun rising from amidst the valley. Northeast India holds something special to experience. From the beauty of the tourist places in Northeast India to the fun-filled activities, there are numerous experiences that we simply cannot afford to miss out. I now bring you 5 of the best Northeast tourist places that we should visit at least once, and surely we will be left waiting more after that. First, let me tell you about the Kasaranga National Park. Declared a UNESCO Heritage Site, the National Park is the home to the one-horned rhinos, which attract tourists from all over the world. Spotting a one-horned rhinoceros in its stomping yard is an experience that we can live to tell your grandchildren. It will be unlike any lore ever told. It is located at Kanchanjunga in Assam. There are 35 species of mammals and hundreds of migratory bird species that fly down every season. Next, I take the pride in sharing few points about Meghalaya. The wettest place in the world finds its home in Meghalaya. Chirapunji, which receives The maximum rainfall in the world is famous for its living road bridges formed due to incessant rain. It is also popular for being one of the best Northeast India destinations for a holiday. We can also set up a camp underneath these bridges and live close to the nature never before. We can also enjoy the tropical flora and fauna while camping under or climbing the road bridges. We shall move on to the Jayantia Hills, which is located in the heart of Meghalaya. Jayantia Hills are stuffed with limestone deposits and are one of the top Northeast tourist attractions. The hills have a number of caves for the explorer in us to enjoy and soothe their mind. Spelunking in these caves can lead us to the number of shallow and some long caves, making it an adventurous attraction in the region. Though it's best to have company during this adventure for a memorable experience. The best time to visit these hills is during summer. Next is the Dampa Tiger Reserve, which is located in Phool Bihar in Mizoram. Spread over an immense 550 square kilometers, the Dampa Tiger Reserve have some beautiful tigers that we can catch sight and capture pictures of. There is no doubt that the sight of a tiger is an experience in itself to cherish for lifelong. The royal look of a tiger and their men acting yet elegant ways are best experienced in person, and that is why visiting this place is a must. Majuli Islands. The river island is situated in the mighty Brahmaputra and is one amazing place to see in the Northeast. It is a cultural hub of the region with a number of tribes calling it their home. The size of the island was originally 1200 square kilometers, but it has now come down to just 420 square kilometers due to the erosion from the Brahmaputra. Nevertheless, it's an astonishing place to witness on your trip. It can be visited any time during the year, but now is the time when people look forward to paying a visit to these islands. It's famous for navigation through the fields on a canoe, an otherworldly experience that you won't find anywhere else. But the point of concern is the islands of Majuli are being eroded by the Brahmaputra every year. They might have last only a couple of years more. Hope you all got a lively experience with me. Thank you.